Good afternoon. Please be seated. On behalf of the faculty, staff, students, and alumni of the Graduate College of Social Work, I am pleased to welcome you to this afternoon's formal gathering of what will be an exciting weekend of celebration for you, the 45th graduating social work class from the GCSW. Before we start, if I could ask you to please silence or turn off your cell phones so we can have 1 hour of uninterrupted meeting. Thank you. Whenever faculty gather for a processional, they are led by the most senior faculty members of that body. This afternoon, three of the Graduate College of Social Work distinguished emeriti faculty greeted the faculty and graduates into the auditorium. I will introduce them later in the program. In 1967, the Texas legislature authorized a graduate social work program to be established in Houston. With a budget of $150,000, 7 faculty, 3 staff, 22 students, 18 women and 4 men, the program began. Today, we will graduate 160 students with over 400 alumni, totaling today 160 graduates. Just as they have done and are doing, you too will make an incredible difference in our community and in the lives of countless numbers of children, families, couples, and seniors. To each of you graduates, congratulations. Learning takes place in many places in a university. Not only the classroom, the student lounge, field placements, but in the hallways and at the underground center over coffee. Student groups also play a vital role in the life of a college. The Graduate College of Social Work is fortunate to have a variety of student groups in place that reflect the breadth of diversity in the college and in the social work profession. These groups organize a variety of activities, ranging from celebrating the Chinese New Year, sponsoring guest lectures and panels, to collecting goods for local nonprofits during the December holiday season. The GCSW student groups include the following: Alliance, Asian American Student Association, Association for Black Social Workers, Clinical Leadership Society, Hispanic Student Association, Macro Association, NASW Houston Chapter, Social Workers for Intercultural Collaboration, Students for the Advancement of International Social Work, Tikkun Olam, and the GCSW student ambassadors who represent the college at various university, state, and national conferences. The one student group that represents all students to the faculty, the dean's office, the university, and the community is the Student Association. Would those of you who served as officers and leaders of any of these associations please stand to be recognized? Thank you. Thank you all for your work in promoting and effectively advocating student interests in the college and the university while promoting the social work profession. I would now like to invite Ms. Sharon Hillman to come forward to announce the recipients of this year's Student Association Awards. Sharon.
Each year, the GCSW Student Association organizes a student body to vote for outstanding students, faculty, staff, and community members who have contributed to the field of social work and social justice and have stood out as leaders in school or in their fields. Now we'd like to present this year's awards. I will read the award, then the recipient for each, and we'd like to ask the recipient of each award to stand after their name is said to be recognized. Award winner, after the convocation is over, please find me to collect your award. The first award is the Barbara Jordan Unity Award. This award is in the name of the first black woman elected to the Texas Senate and the first WS representative for Houston's 18th District, known for her tenacity and perseverance. The recipient of this award is a part-time or advanced standing student who has demonstrated discipline, determination, and a high standard of excellence. Please help me congratulate Esther Garza. The next award is the Jane Addams Award. This award is named for one of the social work profession's founders and examples of conviction put into practice. This award is given to the student who best demonstrates service to the GCSW, professionalism, scholastic achievement, leadership, and the ability to establish and maintain faculty-student support and rapport. Help me congratulate Kelly O'Quinn. The next award is Mahatma Gandhi Peace Award. Gandhi provides the inspiration for the GCSW's unofficial motto, "We must become the change we want to see." And this award is given to the student who most exemplifies the power of this principle. This student is innovative in leadership style, thought, and character, and is known as someone who embodies the change they work to achieve. Help me congratulate Luana Da Silva. Martin Luther King Jr. Social Justice Award. This award is named for one of society's greatest contemporary examples of advocacy, empowerment, and the championing of social justice, and is given to the student who embodies these same principles. As a leader, this award recipient has shown the power to cooperatively determine goals and unite others behind their causes. Please help me congratulate Jorge Olvera. The Mary Richmond Award is given in honor of one of the social works profession's community practice pioneers. The student who receives this award has performed exceptional community service beyond employment or field practicum. Additionally, the recipient of this award represents the epitome of social work values and ethics and supports a traditional casework philosophy. Please help me congratulate Andre Napier. Community Organization and Change for Social Justice Faculty Award. This faculty has demonstrated dedication to building a movement of vulnerable population by working with the people to effect change. Through education, this faculty has engaged students in inspired commitment and action to attain social justice. Please help me congratulate Professor Abba Brown. Outstanding Faculty Award. This award was initiated by the Student Association to honor and recognize a member of the GCSW faculty who demonstrates exceptional class performance, supportive student interaction, professional role modeling, and advocacy on behalf of students. The faculty member chosen for this award will have the honor of placing master's degree hoods on candidates for graduation at today's ceremony. Please help me congratulate Roberta Liao. Outstanding Staff Award. This award is given to honor a staff member who has provided outstanding friendship and support to students throughout the academic year. Although this person may not have instructional interaction with students, he or she is chosen based on their commitment to the GCSW and the promulgation of social work education, values, and ethics. Please help me congratulate Casey McKee. And last, the Humanitarian Award. This award is given to an individual from the community that exemplifies social work through their dedication and efforts to promote social justice and equality. This community leader embodies the core components of social work by promoting the well-being of individuals and communities through social change and honors people's right to self-determination. Please help me congratulate Roberta Liao.
Let's have one more round of applause for all our awardees, please. Moving right along, Anna Johnson will introduce our guest speaker for today.
Anna.
Anna, I love you!
No.
I am very honored to introduce our speaker for today's event, Angela Blanchard. Angela Blanchard is the president and CEO of Neighborhood Centers, Inc., an organization that works to strengthen underserved neighborhoods in a Houston area and serves around 600,000 people a year. With Ms. Blanchard's leadership, Neighborhood Centers remains the largest nonprofit in Texas and is ranked in the top 1% of charitable groups in the nation. Ms. Blanchard has participated in the White House Social Enterprise and Opportunity Series, the Brookings Institution Metropolitan Leadership Council, and the Clinton Global Initiative. The National Underground Railroad Freedom Center has also honored her with the Everyday Freedom Hero Award for her advocacy on the behalf of the nation's working immigrants. She's also a board member at the Greater Houston Partnership, the National Community Advisory Board for JPMorgan Chase, and was named one of the year's most creative people in the country by Fast Company magazine in 2013. She believes communities should not be defined by their degree of brokenness, but rather by their strengths, resources, achievements, hopes, and has repeatedly demonstrated this motto in her work. Please help me in welcoming Angela Blanchard to the podium.
So, Anna, thank you very much. That's always the most awkward part of speaking, is listening to someone talk about you, no? It's true, isn't it? So I'm supposed to first thank the deans. We have an abundance of deans up here today. So may I just thank you all as a group. And there you have it. You have the past, present, future, temporary, and so forth. So, I have to tell you, this is a little secret. I am the least educated person on the stage. So that's a warning. It's a little bit like the thing that comes on the, you know, the bottle of beer. It says, be careful with this. So. That would be me, you know? So you can ask all these really learned people when I'm done whether it's right what I say or not. But I'm really here. I really said yes, first of all, because they said that the graduates wanted me to come, and you are my tribe. So I'm delighted to be here with my tribe. So it's a really important thing that you learn to find your tribe. So here's how I look for my tribe members. Everybody in my tribe runs toward the fire and stays for the hurricane. And I want you to be that kind of tribe member. I'm here to recruit you to be a warrior for the human spirit. Because all across this country and the world, there are communities and families and individuals who are hurting. And I believe that every situation, every community, every family, there are strengths and assets and resources. There are things that give life to families and give life to community. And your job is to shine a light on those. At Neighborhood Centers, we say the change begins with the first new question. You've all been trained to understand and study the problem. And in the world that you're moving into, in the work that you've chosen, the problems are real and the pain is excruciating at times. But you're not there to admire the problem. You're there to help heal the world. So I'm going to tell you a few things today that I've learned in 40 years of this work. And I share them with you because the world needs you. The world needs you. Ferguson needs you. Baltimore needs you. Gulfton needs you. Johannesburg needs you. Across the country, across the world, people are looking for someone willing to step up. Here's the deal. You become a warrior the day you're willing to work on something when you know you may never see it finished, when you know it may never get done, and that it will fall apart over and over and over again before you get to see it work. So I've been, I got that award, you know, for being an advocate for immigrants and for immigration reform. And people always compliment me on that. And I say, I've not done a very good job. Here, 10, 13 years later, it's a mess. So this is what I say, watch this. Okay. That's me on my walker, and I'll still be saying the same thing. So the first thing I want you to know is that it's your job to bring out your big magnifying glass and shine it on the things that give life to individuals, families, and communities, to lift up what works, to find the things that people are already doing that make a difference in their lives, and resource and encourage that. That's your job. We have made so many mistakes studying what's wrong and fixing it. We have taken help, what's meant to be help, and it's been an act of aggression because we fail to listen. I love working in Australia where they have this practice, the Aboriginal people have taught to everyone, which is this practice of deep listening. But you know, I'm Cajun and we like to shorten it. So I like to say, listen twice. Build once. Because in every community, there's something they're already longing for. If you truly want to help, you must understand deeply what that is. Because you can bring resources and you can bring support for that. I say also, the first 1,000 times are the hardest. So this is a part of the conversation that you may or may not like. You are not allowed to whine. You cannot whine. Well, okay, I'm going to amend that. You can whine for about 30 seconds a day. Yeah, and you should have a whine friend or a wine friend, depending on what works. Both of those are good. Now, some of you have parents you can whine to. And I don't have that kind of mama. You know, this is my mama. I'm on my way to the White House, and I am scared because I am meeting with the president, and I am a Cajun girl from Beaumont. And my mother's texting me to say, oh, how do you feel about it? How do you think you're going to do? I said, well, I'm just praying to God. I don't embarrass anybody. I get it all. I don't do anything wrong. I don't, you know. And my mom texts me back right away. God got you the White House. You'd think you could do the rest yourself. So if you have a mama like mine, get a wine friend, because that won't work. But if you're not Nelson Mandela and you didn't spend 25 years in a prison trying to free your country and your people from apartheid, you can't whine. You exist. 6% of the world has an advanced degree. 6% of the world has a graduate degree. You exist in the world in a special place of responsibility and obligation to heal the world, to teach. And when people say to me, I am sick and tired of explaining why it's not the same for a black or brown person to walk down the street when it comes to the police, I say, I don't care if you're sick and tired of explaining that. If you know it and you understand it, it's your job to explain it. The first 1,000 times are the hardest, and after that, it gets easier. It's your job. So here's another thing you get to know. Over the years, I have wanted to dislike some folks a lot. I have gone off sometimes and holed up in a corner and cultivated an active disdain for people. For example, I don't like when people talk about Texas seceding from the United States of America, because I like being a part of the United States of America. But one thing I've learned is that when you commit yourself to something much larger than you, when you dedicate your life to work that eases unnecessary suffering and helps people realize potential, you get to get past the us and them. Because we're all in this together, and every single time, whether it's a city or a family or a community, we try to figure out how to move some of us forward and leave some of us behind. It does not work, and the price tag is huge. So it's all about us. There is no us in them. There's just a giant we. We're all a part of it. You have to dedicate yourself to understanding even those people whose views just torment you. So I have the advantage in with respect to that of being Cajun. So my people got summarily dumped out of Acadia. The British decided that we should swear allegiance to Britain, and we just swore at them. So what happened was the British just removed us and fortunately dropped quite a few of us off in South Louisiana. Well, where I have 237 relatives, and thank God. And so you know, it's a couple of hundred years, right? And there was a big reunion in Acadia. This was 1995, I think. And there was a big discussion about demanding of the British government that they issue, finally, an apology for this horrible thing they had done to my peeps. Well, much like we didn't swear allegiance, they didn't apologize. But in the middle of 2 days of debate about what would constitute something that would allow everyone to move on, one Cajun man from Opelousas, Louisiana, got up and said, "Why don't we forgive them anyway and move on? Because it's time to go dancing." I want to tell you something else. I have worked on things that have been deeply, profoundly rewarding. I have watched as communities have rebuilt. I stood with the people in Lower Ninth after Katrina. I watched and worked with the people in Kinglake, Australia after the hottest fire on earth burned up everything. I've gotten to be in places where people cared so much about community, they'd do anything to bring it back. So from that, I tell you, nothing is more important than community. And you must tend to your community the way you'd care for a garden, or in Cajun terms, you know, weed, water what you want, weed what you don't. But you must take care of community. You must take care of your relationships. I turned 60 last year, and I told everybody I got old. And I meant it, because I figured when you get old, you can say whatever the hell you want to. I'm claiming being old. But you know, at 60, I have friends I've had for 40 years. And I cannot make a 40-year friend at 60. So right now, wherever you are, whatever community you're a part of, whatever friends you hold dear, take care of those relationships. They will allow you to do the work that you're called to do in the world, and the world really, really does need you. And then my friend Meg Wheatley and I teach together a lot, and she likes to say something to wrap up our sessions. And I really love it. And she learned it from a group of women in Africa who had survived something almost unspeakable. And she said to them, "How do you go on? How do you continue to look forward to living and to life?" And they said to her, "We were together. I forget the rest." So we were together. Thank you.
Thank you, Angela. Thank you for your thoughts and comments and the important work that you do on so many people. Again, I ask that we recognize our guest speaker. We now come to the fun part, the awarding of degrees. We will begin with the presentation of the candidates for the doctoral degree in social work, and then the candidates for the master's degree. Will the Doctor of Philosophy candidates please rise? At this time, I would like to ask Dr. Shira Williams-Jennings, Director of the Doctoral Program, to come forward to read the candidates' names for the hooding ceremony.
I now have the pleasure of presenting the candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy. They will be headed by their dissertation chairs. Ginger Siloway Gomelt. Children's Perceptions of Violence, a Thematic Analysis of Students' Essays. She will be hooded by her dissertation chair, Dr. Monique Chung. Alicia LaChapelle. Capping Back, a Grounded Theory on African American Adolescent Males and Emotional Self-Protection. She's hooded by her chair, Dr. Susan Robbins. Melissa Irene Maldonado Torres. Latinas, Latinos, and the Sex Trade, a Qualitative Study on the Perceptions of Customers, Victims, and Service Providers. Hooded by her chair, Dr. Luis Torres. Mark Herrick Trahan. The Role of Paternal Self-Efficacy in Father Involvement. Hooded by his chair, Dr. Monique Chung. Osuke Joskun Yetishtriji. Hooded by her chair, Dr. Luis Torres. Reflections of Turkish Immigrants on Their Adaptation to the United States, a Qualitative Study. Congratulations to our new PhDs.
Once again, let us congratulate our new doctors in social work. Will the Master of Social Work candidates please rise? It is my honor to present these degree candidates who are students in good standing with the university and who have completed all the requirements for the Master of Social Work degree as set forth by the faculty. As the candidates for the master's degrees requested, Professor Roberta Leal will hood each graduate, and Professor Donna Amsberg will clearly announce the name of each of our candidates. And while they're getting ready, I would like to introduce the emeriti faculty on our stage. Please stand when I call your name. Karen A. Holmes, 29 years of service to the college university. Dr. Jean Cantambu Ladding, 34 years of service. And Dr. Dale Alexander, 13 years of service. Please join me in recognizing their contribution to the Graduate College of Social Work. Okay. Almost done. On a roll.
Teresa Adcock. Teresa completed the clinical concentration. She's a Globe Youth Fellow, member of the Golden Key Honor Society, and a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Allison Jane Abdias. Allison completed the clinical concentration with a gerontology specialization. She's an A-Gift Fellow, a founding member of Alliance, and is a member of the Phi Kappa Phi Honor Society. Shirley Ann Addicks, Shirley completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, the Clinical Leadership Society, and the National Association of Social Workers. So. Sheila Monique Anderson, Sheila completed the clinical concentration. Carolina Arenas. Carolina completed the clinical concentration. Oops, I'm sorry. Got carried away. Carolina? Carolina Arenas. Carolina completed the clinical concentration. She participated in the Houston Geriatric Education Center 2014 Interdisciplinary Student Competition and also presented a paper at the North American Christian Social Workers Association National Conference in Annapolis, Maryland. Ali Aronovitz. Ali completed the clinical concentration and was a Globe Youth Fellow. Meredith Christine Atkinson. Meredith completed the clinical concentration. She served as a GCSW Student Association co-president and was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Michael Adair. Michael completed the clinical concentration. Maureen Azajiji. Maureen completed the clinical concentration. Angela Denise Bailey. Angela completed the clinical concentration. Mallory Jill Balkin. Mallory completed the clinical concentration. Emmanuel L. Ben-Edit. Emmanuel completed the macro concentration. He served as a GCSW student ambassador and was also a member of the Members Advocating for Communities Resources and Organization Network. Anna Billingsley. Anna completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow. Robinson Block. Robinson completed the macro concentration. He was a member of the Hispanic Student Association and participated in the Austin Legislative Internship Program, working with State Representative Jessica Farrar. Ashley Brown. Ashley completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society, the Houston Group Psychotherapy Society, and the National Association of Social Work. She completed internships at Baylor College of Medicine and at the Daring Way. And today she's hooded by her sister and our faculty member, Dr. Brené Brown. Laquatia Quinnell Burke. Laquatia completed the clinical concentration with a health disparity specialization. She participated in the China and Hong Kong study abroad trip in summer 2014 and is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Francesca Calhoun. Francesca is completing the clinical concentration. She has also served as an at-large representative for the Clinical Leadership Society. Jen C. Claude. Jen C. completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and was a Globe Youth Fellow. Carolina Coronel Bertero. Carolina completed the clinical concentration with a social work practice with Latino specialization. She was awarded the George Foundation Scholarship and is also a trauma fellow. Jaysa Curry. Jaysa completed the clinical concentration. She was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Luana Meireles da Silva. Luana completed the clinical concentration with a political social work specialization. She was a Globe Bilingual Fellow, a trauma fellow, and participated in the 2015 Practicum in Advocacy at the United Nations 59th Commission on the Status of Women. Ang Wai Dang. Ang completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Bilingual Fellow. She was a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and a UH Graduate College of Social Work Student Association. Candy Deshotel. Candy completed the clinical concentration. She was a member of the GCSW Student Association and completed internships with Texas Children's Protective Services and DaVita Dialysis. She also attended the National Kidney Day at the Capitol in Austin, Texas. Carlos Diaz. Carlos completed the clinical concentration. He was also a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Jenny Din. Jenny completed the clinical concentration with a gerontology specialization. Lakia Sherry Dixon. Lakia completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and participated in the Lone Star Behavioral Health Internship Program. Ashley Stout Duplantis. Ashley completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers and the Lambda chapter of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Fairley Virginia Edlington. Fairley completed the clinical concentration. She was a child trauma and a Globe Youth Fellow. She was a member of the GCSW Student Association and the Clinical Leadership Society. Chinyere Yvonne Agaga. Chinyere completed the clinical concentration. She is an honor member of the Clinical Leadership Society, Phi Alpha Honor Society, and the National Association of Social Workers. She also received the Social Work Dean's Advisory Council Scholarship, the Barbara Winston in Honor of Catherine White Scholarship, and Phi Alpha Scholarship Awards. Patria Katrine Ellis. Patria completed the clinical concentration with a health disparities specialization. Tecelia Esther Spence. Tecelia completed the macro concentration. She's a recipient of the 2014 Hamill Foundation Scholarship. She's also a member of Phi Alpha Honor Society, the National Association of Social Workers, the Houston Gerontological Society, and National Geriatric Care Management Association. Shay Allison Everett. Shay is completing the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, Clinical Leadership Society, and National Association of Social Workers. She's also a recipient of the Ruth Mary A. Goldman Scholarship. Hannah Foshi. Hannah completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Houston Group Psychotherapy Society and the National Association of Social Workers. Daniela Fragoso. Daniela completed the macro concentration. She was a member of the GCSW Hispanic Student Association. Kristen Ann Franklo. Kristen completed the clinical concentration. Esther Marie Garza. Esther completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow and studied abroad in China and Hong Kong. She co-facilitated a workshop at North American Association of Christians and Social Work Conference and also participated in the University of Houston's Graduate Research and Scholarship Project Day. Angie Gomez. Angie completed the macro concentration. She was a member of the GCSW Hispanic Student Association and participated with community associations working towards leadership development of minorities, including the National Hispanic Professionals Organization and Latina Women in Leadership. She also participated in the No Place for Hate Summit on Bully-Free Campuses with Professor Roberta Liao. Maricela Gomez. Maricela is completing the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow. She also participated in the Austin Legislative Internship Program where she worked for Representative Garnet Coleman and is a member of the Clinical Leadership Society. Candy A. Gonzalez. Candy completed her clinical concentration. Jessica Navarez Gonzalez. Jessica completed the clinical concentration. She was a fellow of the Bilingual Globe Leaders of Behavioral Health Education Program and is one of the 8 students in the state of Texas to have received the Ima Hogg Mental Health Scholarship. Allison Ann Gray. Allison completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers and participated in summer internships with Jewish Family Services and Easter Seals in 2014. She's also a member of the Phi Kappa Phi Honor Society. Denise Marie Greenwood. Denise completed the clinical concentration. She served as president of the GCSW's Clinical Leadership Society and was a National Trauma Fellow Program Fellow. She is also a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Lynn Ann Hijack. Lynn completed the clinical concentration. She received the Globe Youth Scholarship and is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Crystal Hamilton Dorel Lee Yen. Crystal is completing the clinical concentration. She's a member of the GCSW Student Association, the National Association of Social Workers, and the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Crystal also participated in the 2013 study abroad in Turkey. Madeline Hartman Vaughn. Madeline completed the clinical concentration. She's also a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and the Phi Alpha Phi Honor Society. Rita Holliday. Rita completed the macro concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and also students for the advancement of International Social Work Organization. Holly Ann Horan. Holly completed the clinical concentration. She was a member of the Clinical Leadership Society, the Student Veterans of America, and the GCSW Student Association. She's also a member of the National Association of Social Workers and the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Tabeen Charisma Islam. Tabeen completed the clinical concentration. She served as a student ambassador for the GCSW and was a Globe Award recipient for behavioral health workforce education and training for professionals. She is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Rhonda K. Jackson. Rhonda completed the clinical concentration with a gerontology specialization. She also received the Isla Carol Turner Fellowship of Gerontological Social Work. Keisha Nicole Jacobs. Keisha completed the clinical concentration. She also was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Anna Novak Johnson. Anna completed the macro concentration. She served as director of the Macro Student Network, was a student association representative, and served as a GCSW student ambassador. She also worked as a graduate student assistant in the Department of Development. Lisa Georgette Johnson. Lisa completed the clinical concentration. She was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Tori Beth Johnson. Tori completed the clinical concentration. She served as secretary of the GCSW Student Association. She's also a member of the Clinical Leadership Society, the National Honor Society of Phi Kappa Phi, and is both a member of the vice president of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Ella Karasevic. Ella completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and a National Association of Social Workers. She also was a recipient of the Phi Alpha Honor Society Scholarship. Priscilla Kennedy. Priscilla completed the macro concentration with a political social work specialization. Brittany Kibbe. Brittany completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and was also a Globe Youth Fellow. Angela Killian. Angela completed the clinical concentration. She was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Lori Owen Kosarek. Lori is completing the clinical concentration. Glendy Lara. Glendy completed the macro concentration with a social work practice with Latino specialization. David Michael Lantini. David completed the clinical concentration. He is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, Clinical Leadership Society, and the National Association of Social Workers. Brittany Irwin Lonnen. Brittany completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, Clinical Leadership Society, and the National Association of Social Workers. Princess Leggington. Princess is completing the macro concentration. She's a member of the Macro Student Network and the National Association of Social Workers. Zachary Lessig. Zach completed the clinical concentration. He served as a treasurer for the GCSW Student Association and is also the incoming Phi Alpha Honor Society treasurer. He is a Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars inductee, was a Globe Youth Fellow, and is a member of the Clinical Leadership Society. Jennifer Lynn Lombardi. Jennifer completed the clinical concentration. She was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Jackie Long. Jackie completed the clinical concentration. She was also a Globe Youth Fellow. Daniela Elizabeth Lopez. Daniela completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow. She is also a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, the Clinical Leadership Society, and the Students for the Advancement of International Social Work. Zelda Martinez. Zelda completed the clinical concentration. She was a member of the Hispanic Student Association, Students for the Advancement of International Social Work, and the UH chapter of UNICEF. She was also a bilingual Globe Fellow, recipient of the Dean Advisory Council Scholarship, and participated in social work at the United Nations Conference. She is a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and a National Association of Social Workers. Alicia Matthews. Alicia completed the clinical concentration. She was an advanced standing student and recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Rachel McMillan. Rachel completed the clinical concentration. Yvonne Annette Mendoza. Yvonne completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Bilingual Fellow and participated in the practicum and in advocacy at the United Nations. Tiara A. McKell. Tiara is completing the clinical concentration. She is a member of the National Association of Social Workers and the National Association of Black Social Workers. She currently serves as a field advocate for the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention and is a theater teacher director at Kip Houston High School. Hazel Monterosa. Hazel completed the clinical concentration. She's also a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and was a recipient of the Hogg Foundation for Mental Health Bilingual Scholarship. Frances Marie Moreno. Frances completed the clinical concentration. She was a member of the GCSW Student Association, the Hispanic Student Association, and Students for the Advancement of International Social Work. She's also a member of the National Association of Social Workers and participated in Social Work Day at the United Nations. Diana Flores Munoz. Diana completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, the National Association of Social Workers, and the Clinical Leadership Society. Samantha Lee Myers. Samantha completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha and Golden Key International Honor Societies. She's also a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and the National Association of Social Workers. Andre Napier. Andre completed the clinical concentration. He is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and was a Globe Youth member. He is a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Catherine Nazaroff. Catherine completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers and Clinical Leadership Society. She will also be a fellow at the Council on Alcohol and Drugs next year. Lynn Wade. Lynn completed the clinical concentration. Kendra Deneen Oglesby. Kendra completed the clinical concentration with a gerontology specialization. She's also an AGIF fellow and member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Jorge Eduardo Olvera. Jorge completed the macro concentration. He is an AGIF fellow, served as the president of the Hispanic Student Association, and was a GCSW ambassador. He was captain of the GCSW Kittage team and is also a 2015 Outstanding Field Student of the Year Award recipient.
I want a copy, Jorge.
Keely Renee O'Quinn. Keely completed the macro concentration. She served as program development coordinator for the Macro Network and was a Hamel Foundation scholarship recipient. Michelle Parker Schauer. Michelle is completing the clinical concentration with a social work practice with Latino specialization. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers, Phi Alpha Honor Society, and Students for the Advancement of International Social Work. She's also a Globe Youth Fellow. Courtney Penson. Courtney is completing the macro concentration. She also served as a secretary for the Macro Student Network. Kirby James Peterson. Kirby is completing the clinical concentration with a social work with Latino specialization. He was a Globe Youth Fellow and a Hogg Foundation bilingual scholar. He was also a member of the GCSW Hispanic Student Association and is a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Gareth Fennig. Gareth completed the clinical concentration. He was both a trauma and Globe Youth Fellow. He is also a member of the Clinical Leadership Society. Jessica Sirwa-Poku. Jessica is completing the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and also Students for the Advancement of International Social Work. La Patria Raquel Porter. La Patria completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Holly Gwynn Pryor. Holly completed the clinical concentration with a health disparity specialization. She served as the GCSW Student Association co-president and participated in the Child Trauma and Globe Youth Fellowships. She is also a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, the National Association of Social Workers, a lifetime member of the Clinical Leadership Society, and is a member of the Society of Leadership and Success. Megan Eilish Quinn. Megan completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society, Alliance, the National Association of Social Workers, and the Phi Kappa Phi Honor Society. She served as president of Students for the Advancement of International Social Work, was a Globe Fellow, and participated in Social Work Day at the United Nations headquarters in New York City. Megan was also a recipient of the Dean's Advisory Council and the Graduate Student Workers Scholarship. Lisa Marie Richardson. Lisa completed the clinical concentration. She currently works at Lone Star Behavioral Health, providing therapeutic services to adults who suffer with severe and persistent mental illness. Amelia Vasquez Rivera. Amelia completed the clinical concentration with a gerontology specialization. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Letitia Rockwell. Letitia completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the National Association of Social Workers, is a U.S. Army veteran, and is a licensed master social worker. Matthew Rogers. Matthew completed the clinical concentration. He was a member of the GCSW Student Association and also served as a GCSW Student Ambassador. Cherie Lynn Rogers. Cherie completed the clinical concentration. She's also a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Witho Yvette Rogers. Witho completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Fellow and is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Tracy Rubio. Tracy completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Melissa Sanchez. Melissa is completing the clinical concentration. She's a member of Phi Alpha Honor Society. Christine Marie Schisler. Christine completed the clinical concentration. She participated in the Trauma Program Fellowship, received the Dean's Advisory Council and Presidential Scholarships, and was a member of the GCSW Student Association. She is a lifetime member of the Mu Lambda Chapter of Phi Alpha Honor Society, the Honor Society of Phi Kappa Phi, and the Clinical Leadership Society. She's also a member of the National Association of Social Workers. Bonnie Schultz. Bonnie is completing her clinical concentration. Kendalyn Franchelle Schenkel. Kendalyn completed the clinical concentration with a health disparity specialization. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, Clinical Leadership Society, and served as Vice President of Students for the Advancement of International Social Work. She was a Globe Youth Fellow and recipient of the Barbara Winston in honor of Catherine White Scholarship. Chiquita Shanae Sherman. Chiquita completed the clinical concentration. She served as Vice President of GCSW Student Association, was a Globe Fellow, and was the first place poster presentation winner at the GCSW Research Conference in 2013. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Janae Michelle Simon. Janae completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society and was an IEFS scholarship recipient. Ebony Ashante Sims. Ebony is completing the clinical concentration with gerontology specialization. She serves as secretary for the Clinical Leadership Society. Yolette Linnell Sneed. Yolette completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society, the National Association of Black Social Workers, and the National Association of Social Workers. She is also a member of the National Child Welfare Workforce Institute, the Chi Sigma Iota Counseling Honor Society, and the Phi Delta Kappa International Society. She was a recipient of the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship. Esmeralda Lara Sotelo. Esmeralda completed the clinical concentration. She was also a Globe Fellow at the GCSW. Mai Spickelmeyer-Engel. Mai completed the clinical concentration. She's a Globe Youth Fellow and served as treasurer of the Clinical Leadership Society. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society, the Phi Kappa Phi Honor Society, and the National Association of Social Workers. Katie Elizabeth Stavanoa. Katie completed the clinical concentration. She served as a Clinical Leadership Society board member and also participated in the Globe and Youth Fellowships. Tisha Stevenson. Tisha completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow and also was a recipient of the Dean's Advisory Council Scholarship. Alexa Taylor. Alexa completed the clinical concentration. Renee Thomas. Renee completed the clinical concentration. She is also a member of the Clinical Leadership Society. Constance Lee Thompson. Constance completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. Caitlin Sarah Throgmorton. Caitlin completed the clinical concentration. She was also a Globe Youth Fellow. Lee Alana Todd. Lee completed the clinical concentration. She served as an officer for the Clinical Leadership Society and is a member of the National Honor Mu Lambda Chapter of the Phi Alpha and Phi Kappa Phi Honor Society. She was also a Globe Youth Fellow. Julie Catherine Trogel. Julie is completing the clinical concentration. She also completed internships with Catholic Charities and Refugee Resettlement and the Lovett Center, a community of helping professionals. Firuze Tuller. Firuze completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and Alliance. Pilar Valenzuela Silva. Pilar completed the clinical concentration. She served as an officer for the Hispanic Student Association as a GCSW student ambassador. She was awarded Outstanding Field Practicum Student for Foundation Year Placement in 2014. She was also a recipient of the Barbara Winston in honor of Catherine White and Barbara and Ernest Henley Endowment for Family Health Scholarships. Chandra Martel Ward. Chandra is completing the clinical concentration. Tennille Whitlock. Tennille completed the clinical concentration. She received the Child Welfare Education Project Scholarship and is a member of the CWEP Student and Alumni Association. Jessica Ray Witt. White. Jessica completed the clinical concentration. She was a Globe Youth Fellow and is both a member and officer of the Phi Alpha Honor Society. She's also a member of the National Association of Social Workers and Clinical Leadership Society. Brittany Charday Williams. Brittany is completing the clinical concentration. She completed internships at Hospice Care Team and the Michael E. DeBakey Veteran Affairs Medical Center. She also participated in the International Social Work course that involved a study abroad trip to Germany, Belgium, and the Netherlands. Saida Evelyn Jimenez Williams. Saida completed the clinical concentration with a social work practice with Latino specialization. She was a recipient of the Globe Leaders of Behavioral Health Fellowship and is a member of the Phi Alpha Honor and Clinical Leadership Societies. Grace Yaw Wilson. Grace completed the macro concentration. Akua Zellner. Akua completed the clinical concentration and was also Globe Youth Fellow. Wendy Marie Scholl. Wendy completed the clinical concentration. She's a member of the Clinical Leadership Society and the National Association of Social Workers.
Can we have another round of applause for all our graduates, please? Before we conclude, I think it would only be appropriate for the graduates to thank those special people in their family, their companions, their friends, for helping them through this education. So would the graduates please join me? Okay, we can continue that after the show. A college becomes a great college based on two integral pieces. Its graduates who do incredible work, make a difference in the community, and the faculty who push, prod to the, and help them to excel in their studies. In all honesty, behind me sits one of the premier faculty groups associated with any social work program in the country. They reflect and represent that which is best in our community. They have a passion for teaching excellence, a compassion for those who are hurting, and an undying resolve to bring about a just society for all people. They pushed you to be the professional you can be and will be. I would like to introduce the faculty and ask that they stand when their name is called. Please hold your applause until all the faculty have been introduced. Andy Ackenbaum, Donna Amsberg, Stephen Applewhite, Patrick Bordnick, Abba Brown, Brene Brown, Jody Berger Cardoso, Monique Chung, Ira Colby, Larry Hill, Shira Williams Jennings, Roberta Leo, Patrick Leung, Virginia Lucas, Sarah Narendorf, Jamie Parker, Danielle Parrish, Suzanne Pritzker, Susan Robbins, Alan Rubin, McLean Sampson, Isabel Torres, Luis Torres. Join me in congratulating our faculty. Not able to attend here today, our faculty, Reverend William Lawson and Nobel laureate Jody Williams. Besides the faculty, there's another group of persons who are the unsung heroes in our college. those individuals who provide the critical support daily to ensure that the college works. This is the staff of the college. A number of the staff have joined in celebrating your success today. These include colleagues in the admissions office, student affairs, alumni, business, field education, David Underwood chapter of the National Leadership Alliance, the dean's office, research center, computer lab, and the crew of persons who day in and day out clean our building. I ask that our wonderful staff stand to be recognized. The graduation committee put in a great deal of work in organizing today's program. Would the members of the graduating committee please stand so that we may thank you? As we finish this afternoon's event, the faculty will exit the stage, followed by the graduates and then their guests. Ecclesiastes 3 says, "To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven." Some of you may remember the Byrds' 1969 song entitled "Turn, Turn, Turn." Well, this has been a year of transitions in the College of Social Work. Dean Ira Colby stepping down after 15 years, the loss of two emeritus faculty, Dr. Gerson David, 40 years of service to the college, passed away this year. So did Dr. Mary Lewis, after 29 years of service. In addition, four faculty are retiring at the end of this academic year. And the college lost another close friend from the community, an Auschwitz survivor named Walter Casey, who told his very emotional and personal story to our incoming students at orientation for several years. He taught us to appreciate every day in our lives and show gratitude to our parents. On the more positive side, this year we have hired three full-time tenure-track faculty and two visiting faculty starting in the fall, and we hired a new dean. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Alan Detlef, who will say hello.
Thank you. Thank you, Dean Reifel. I was very pleased to be invited to attend your ceremony today so that I would have the opportunity to say congratulations to all of you. So congratulations on this tremendous accomplishment. I want all of you to know how very excited I am to be joining the University of Houston and the Graduate College of Social Work. Over the last several months, I had the opportunity to meet several of you, and I've heard much about you from the faculty and the students as part of my, the faculty and the staff as part of my interviewing process. And it was learning about all of you and the incredible successes that you've had and the amazing work that you're doing in your agencies and in the community that was really the most exciting thing to me in thinking about coming to the University of Houston and the College of Social Work. So I'm very much looking forward to being here and being dean of the college, but I want you to know the big impact that you had on me as I was considering coming to the College of Social Work. So I'm very disappointed that I wasn't able to get to know all of you as students, but I'm very hopeful that I'll have the opportunity to know you as alumni. So I hope over the next year to see you in the community, to visit you at your agencies, and I really want to hear from you and learn from you about your experiences in the College of Social Work, what we did well, what we can be doing better, and as you progress in your career in your agencies, I'd really like to hear from you about what you're learning, about what the needs of the community is, what the needs of the community are, and what we need to be doing to be sure that we're preparing students to effectively meet those needs and meet the challenges that clients in the Houston area are facing. I also hope that you'll consider staying involved with the college. As your career progresses, I hope you'll consider being a field instructor for our students or teaching a class as an adjunct professor and just coming back to the college and visiting us, perhaps thinking about pursuing your PhD in a few years. So please stay in touch, please stay connected, please stop by and see me anytime that you're at the college. As I said, I really want to hear from you and learn from you. and get to know all of you. So thank you again for the invitation to be here and to share this with you. Congratulations, and I'm looking forward to getting to know each of you.
So to our graduates, this is also a time of transition. From graduate social work students to practicing social workers, from self-motivated learners to dedicated professionals, from a new beginning social worker to a well-educated and committed social worker ready to reduce social and economic injustice. On this great day, we have high hopes for you. We hope that you will find good and satisfying ways to integrate your professional and personal lives. We understand that isn't easy to do. We hope that you will invest strategically in your professional career to become the best that you can be and to meet the needs of those whom you will serve. We hope that you will engage with the changing healthcare system with high integrity and full commitment to the NASW Code of Ethics. We hope that you will work to ensure self-determination for your clients, pursue best practices, and engage in empirical research. We hope that you will maintain strong bonds with your classmates, the university, and the Graduate College of Social Work. And finally, we hope that you will be inspired, caring, passionate social workers working to increase social and economic justice for all. Yours is indeed a high calling. Today you are launched on an exciting ride. You will certainly not be bored. So on this important day, we wish you, the members of the class of 2015, much success and satisfaction in making a difference in the lives of others. We are all counting on you. May peace and justice be with each and all of you. Thank you and congratulations. Bring your water bottles with you, okay? Are you ready?